Hello viewers, welcome to my channel and my dear cadets. After a long back, we have been started again a series on NCC common subject SDSW, and today we are going to see a lesson on national integration, and this is the lesson 1, religious culture, traditions and customs of India. I am a retired Lieutenant Commander Dr. Sajid Hundekar, Three Maharashtra Naval NCC Associate Professor in Head, Department of Geology, AKI, Pune College of Arts, Science, Commerce, CAM, Pune, Maharashtra, India. I have served 20 years in Three Maharashtra Naval NCC and retired last 2 years back, and now due to the pandemic, I got a chance to learn how to make the videos recording and upload on YouTube. So today, this is a fantastic opportunity. I have got it. Now I wanted to give a written to my NCC cadet, the future NCC cadets who are there, who are coming regularly. For them, this will be a source will be there of common subjects SDSW. I try myself whether I can use Hindi also, but especially the naval subjects are there in the English they have to write, but most of the time I'm going to use the English language. Say, we'll start with this. Yes. Now, what you are going to make out, this is what my fourth video, already three videos I have been uploaded now, NCC alumni have been uploaded, the NCC organization, third one will be there on benefits of incentive or incentives to NCC cadets. So those who are new to this, my channel, they can go and see the previous three also, and might be in the next. I'm going to upload totally around 80 to 85 videos on SDSW common syllabus, and if I get a time, then you can go for the naval subjects also. So now today's lecture I have been dividing into this particular topic, that first in the introduction what we are going to make out, the India is a multi-religious democratic country. It is the biggest democratic country where we have multi-religious are there. There are six major religions in India. Yes, there are the big, what if you take the percentage, count them, there are the six major religions are there, with Hindus compromising 83.5%, Muslims 0.7%, Christians 2.44%, Sikhs 1.79%, and others will be 1.5%. This is the all record I am going to get from the NCC Directorate website, the syllabus, the SDSW common syllabus, then from there I taken out. The historical analysis has proved that the religion has played an obstructive role in the rise of nationalism. Yes, the Rashtriya Ekatma ke liye ye jo hai, ye ek hurdle ban chuka hai, religion. Anyone, anytime they can play the role of the politicians, and they can whatever the religions are there, they have been fighting together. So that is the main hurdle is there to make the progression. Otherwise, India becomes the superpower in the next 20-30, but now I hope 20-50, there will be a competition between India and China. China is ahead of India in all manufacturing sectors, and we are depend on the China raw material. Everything will be there. The world itself has been paralyzed by the China. Now everyone has seen in the COVID-19 pandemic how we have been dependent on the China. So the public has now realized that the fact that religion is a private affair. Yes. Now due to this, whatever the incidents which has happened in the past, and from there we have learned the lesson that realize the fact that religion is a private affair of an individual, and it should not be mixed with the political affairs of the state. This is why the most of the advanced democratic states have adopted secularism with their constitution, which is a factor for unity in multi-religious societies like ours. The main religions of India now, one by one we'll see. These are the points which are there, which will be asked in the examination B set or C set. Religion of Hindu is experience, attitude of mind. It is idea, but it is a power, not an intellectual proportion, but a life of conviction. It is a consciousness of ultimate reality. Man become aware of God through experience. Yes, that is the main Hinduism is there. Man become aware of God through experience. The source of Hindu thought is the Vedas. Yes, that is a very important one. Whatever the Hindu thought is there, it is in the Vedas. The Hindu believe in meditation and yoga. Remember these points. The goal of religious quest is earned by intellectual and moral discipline. Hindu believe in rebirth. Remember, Hindus believe in rebirth, spirit and salvation. Perfection in life as per the Hinduism is attained through the knowledge of truth. The theory of Hinduism lays stress on bhakti, karma and rebirth. Remember these three words. Bhakti, karma and rebirth. Next, what we have is the Islam. Islam means the submission or resignation to the Allah or God. The Quran is the highest authority, is revealed and created, being the eternal word of God incarnate. All the prophets from Adam to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the book which is revealed to them are regarded as the religious heritage of Islam. Muslims have to bear witness to their oneness of God. Yes, remember, here Muslims bear witness to the oneness of the God and message of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, has to observe prayer 5 times daily with a weekly Juma prayers on Friday noon. They keep down to dust fast, purity of soul in 9th month of Ramzan. Yes, the Ramzan comes in the 9th month of Islamic calendar, and they have the fasting for 30 days of the Islamic year. Muslims and who can afford make pilgrimage to Hajj once in a lifetime. If he is affordable, having a money, sufficient money, then he can go in a lifetime once the pilgrimage of Hajj to the Saudi. The Islamic teaching highlights the purity of life, charity to the poor and spread the brotherhoods. So these are the three important messages: purity of life, charity to the poor and spread the brotherhoods. Next one is the Christianity. Christianity was founded by Jesus Christ, command the largest following in the world. Christ was born in 4 BC in Judea. He started preaching about the kingdom of God when he was 30. His activities roused the opposition of the Jewish high priest, who accused him. He was crucified on the order of Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor. Christianity preaches charity, love and peace. Remember these three words. The Christianity preaches charity, love and peace. The message of Jesus Christ is given in the Holy Bible. Yes, the Bible is the book of Christians. Then Quran is the book of Muslims, that is the Islam. And the Vedas are the Hindus. The Christianity is not a religion, but a way of life, which guides the actions and the life for a mental peace and love of humanity. Jainism. Jainism derives its name from Jaina, the conqueror. Mahavira belonging to a princely family in Vaishali. At the age of 30, he renounced the world and spent 12 years in austerity and meditation in the search of truth. At the age of 47, while meditating, he received enlightenment. As per the Jainism teachings, anger, pride, deception, greed must be conquered by the 10 best virtues, such as forgiveness, humility, straightforwardness, contentment, truthfulness, restraint, austerity, purity, chastity and renunciation. To keep himself steady on the path of liberalization and destroy the karma, a monk has to bear all the trouble that might cause him in pains. The monk has to practice austerity, external and internal. It is a pure meditation which ultimately leads to the liberation. Buddhism was founded by Gautam Buddha, who was the son of Indian prince Suddhodan. The sorrow and suffering of the world tormented his heart and abandoned his house and started pursuant for the enlightenment. Gautam found enlightenment when meditating under a peepal tree at the age of 42. Buddha preached emancipation from cycle of rebirth, nirvana. Yes, remember the word nirvana can be attained by the path of self-purification with doctrine of life and mercy. Buddhism is essentially a religion of kindness, humanity and equality. It denounces all claims to superiority on grounds of birth and the caste. Sikhism, the God, the original Guru, imparted the message to his disciple Nanak, who having abode in divine spirit became the Guru himself. The message known as Gurmat, he who follows the teaching of Gurmat is a pure person and known as Sikh. Remember the Gurmat, and those who follow it, the pure person is known as Sikh. The same spirit was passed on to the successive Gurus, and ultimately the divine spirit has been passed on to the sacred script of Guru Granth Sahib. Remember this one. In the fill in the blanks or MCQ, match the following. Guru Granth Sahib, that is the Sikhism. The teachings of Sikhism are that God is one, equality in society, leading of life of purity are the important one. The institution of Gurudwara and common kitchen, Langar, yes, remember these two words, Gurudwara, Langar are the noble examples of the equality in Sikhism. Culture of India, dimension of Indian culture, various races has been coming to India from time immemorable. The civilization of these races differ a great deal from one another. On entering India, they had conflict with the earlier inhabitants of the country. पिछले इतने सालों से जितने लोगों ने इंडिया पे कॉन्कर करने की कोशिश की, उन्होंने यहाँ के लोगों को डिफीट किया और यहाँ पर बस गए और उन्हीं की सोच लेकर लोग चल पड़े. इस तरह से यहाँ पर बहुत सारे सिविलाइजेशन आ चुके हैं. Dimension of the Indian culture. These conflicts affect their respective culture, and through the process of assimilation and synthesize, the culture grow in all the more richer. Yes, according to J. H. Hunton, the oldest race reaching India was Negrito. Yes, the old race which is reaching India is Negrito. They were not very high from the point of view of civilization. Negritos race, they did not know how to make use of the instrument made of stones, bones, how to cultivate the land, how to make earthen wares, or how to build houses. They don't know anything, Negrito. They are now found only in Andaman and Andaman Islands. After the Negrito race came the proto-australoids or primitive Australian race. They are specially found in central India or south the East India in the present age. Proto-Australian race, they are also Austric in English and Agniya in Hindi. Santal, Munda, Birho, Asur, Cobra, Kurg, Jong, such other tribes are related to the proto-Australoid race. The people of Australoid race influence the material and religion of life in India. Indians learned how to cultivate the land with the help of pickaxe to grow rice, bananas, coconuts, brinjals, betel leaves, lemons, jambo fruit and cotton from them. The interesting stories in Mahabharata or Ramayana about Vasuki, the ruler in Patal Lok, the origin of creation from the snake and eggs. Interesting stories about Ganesh, extra have been taken from the myths of these races. Perhaps this is a very race talk of Indians, but how count the dates according to moon phases and fixation scale, the festivals, etc. Now the next comes the Dravidian race. The people of Dravidian or Mediterranean race came to India after the pro-Australoid race. They were more civilized than the people of both the races which came to India earlier one, under the influence of new gods and new methods of worship, came to Indian religious field. In fact, the word puja, worship, belonging to the Dravidian language. The acceptance of an ideal as a representative of some god, or to offer it flowers, tree leaves, to offer it vermilion or sandal paste, to burn incense before it, to ring bells, to sing, to dance before it, to offer or accept sweets, and such other ways to worship was given to India by the Dravidians. So these are the things which have been given by the Dravidian to Indian. The chief or new gods who begin to be worshipped under the influence of Dravidians were Shiva, Uma, Kartikeya, Hanuman, Shitala and Ganesh, etc. Under the Dravidian influence, the number of gods increased. God, goddesses, village gods, family god, and other god of Hindus religion, supposed to be 330 million in number, are all of the result of their influence. The importance of sacred places of worship increased under the influence of the Dravidians. In the same way, they are also preached the worship of the trees, like the worship of Tulsi, Banyan, people, Bale, and many others. It was the Dravidians who gave Indians the festival of Holi and Basant. After the next one, they come in the Aryans. After the Dravidians, the next one, Aryan race, which has come out to India. Aryan made the greatest contribution towards the development of Indian culture. It is their tongue which is also used today in major parts of India. Their Vedas are the main roots to Indian culture. The contribution of Aryans towards the Indian culture has thus described by Dr. Jatunath Sarkar as a feeling of sympathy and adjustment, a wonderful evolution of science and philosophy. Fixation of adjustment among different castes through their principle of Varna system spread the civilization among the demons and the wild tribes through the Tapovan system. Then the Muslim race came to India. The Muslim came to India after the Aryans. In this book, the title Influence of Islam on Indian Culture, Dr. Tarachand has written that the influence of Muslims on the various parts of Indian life has been very great, and this influence has been seen especially in Hindu customs also, on the very minute things of their family, on music, dress, cooking methods, marriage tradition, festivals, fairs, on the institutions and the manner of the Maratha, Rajput and the Sikh courts. On the very minute things of the family, music, dress, cooking methods, marriage tradition, festival fair, on the institution and manner of the Maratha, Rajput and the Sikh courts. Now the influence of the British. After the Muslims, the British deeply influenced all the aspects of Indian culture. They spread the English language, brought hundreds of English words into the Indian language. Influence of the Western culture on the prose, novel, one-act plays, poetry, etc., Indian literature can clearly be seen. Western education created a wave of reformation in the whole country. On the other hand, the ideas of the equality, freedom, nationality help in uprooting the social evil like a sati custom, killing of female child, child marriage, prohibition of widow marriage. On the other hand, they create a political awakening in the country. The present form of administration in India is the outcome of the great influence of the British ideology. The present economic organization, joint stock companies, managing agencies, big factories, production through machines, railways, telegraphs, telephone, aeroplanes and other means of conveyance and communication were brought to India from the West. The influence has regularly been on the increase, and it is needed for the country's progress, although the assimilation is equally necessary. India is multiracial, multilingual civilization, which is rich cultural heritage and has provided peaceful atmosphere for the development of many religions. Indian culture and the customs are influenced by these religions. The customs of India depict very colorful panorama. These are certain customs which are prevalent in a particular region, religion, and some are common to the all religions of the country. Next, festivals. Indian festivals are famous in the world. Most of the festivals are related to the change weather, crop, harvesting, since India is the agro-based industry or economy. The most famous Indian festivals are Diwali, Holi, Dussehra, and Basant Panchami. There are certain festivals which are prevalent in a particular region only, like Bihu in Assam. Remember, these are the word Bihu in Assam, Baisakhi in Punjab, Diwali, Holi, Dussehra, and Basant Panchami. They are the main festivals of India. Then the customs and traditions. Indian customs of various types, mostly related to local customs, caste customs, and family customs. So here we have local custom, caste custom, family customs. There are different customs of Hindu marriage as compared to Muslim marriage or a Sikh marriage. Similarly, there is a different customs of festival celebration. All these customs have been provided by the laws. Certain religion customs pertain to a particular region only, like Mundan ceremony in Hindus, naming ceremony in Sikh. And these customs have religious values and are means of entertainment also. There are some customs regarding dresses and ornamentation of women, and these are associated with the particular regions, which give a very colorful dimension to the Indian customs and tradition. Similarly, all religions have their distinctive ornaments. Every religion has its own ornament. India, being a big country with a different dresses and religion, has a rich custom related to festival, religious ceremony, dresses and marriages, architect, painting, song, dance and food habits. The customs and traditions of India through varied has a binding force in them, which ultimately serving a unifying factor of secular India. In the conclusion, India being a multilingual, multiracial, multi-religious, secular society has a vast pool of custom and traditions. Today, most of our modern thinking has been broken all the barriers of the in the society. People has become very more tolerant and celebrate more festival, even if they have happened to be belonging to other religions. They wholeheartedly join all the celebrations in India. So this is what we have, the first part, that is the national integration topic 1. So that has been covered now. This is the fourth episode of our NCC syllabus. Thank you. Have a nice day.